So everything was going good with these new extruders until yesterday when one of the prints came to check on it, and it just like the extruder had just dug into the print and was scraping along the surface of the platform, and you can see all the, scraping that it did, and this was all that was left. And then when the extruder went to the side, like a bunch of even more than that of plastic squirted out that was like compressed against the surface. And I was trying to figure out what happened initially, and it looks like this is the one that's still good. It wasn't being used. It looks like this one, the extruder heater block and nozzle came out. You can see it's lower than this one. This one you can just see the tip of the extruder sticking out, and then this one is lower. And in fact, when it does, after it does a home calibration, it should clear the platform with just like 0.2 millimeters of space or 0.1 millimeter of space, something like that. And it's not even clear, it's just straight up hitting the platform. And this one is still fine. It's still clearing the platform once you do the home calibration. So something happened where this nozzle dropped, and we'll see. I'm gonna take this extruder apart, and we'll see what's going on in there. We'll see how easy it is to repair these extruders. This is what I was talking about, where it's nice. It would be nice to just be able to hot swap these extruders. So the first thing to do, at least, which is easy, is just remove the power from it right now until I need it again. That's gonna be done pretty easily. Okay, so to remove the outer shroud cover, you just take these hex screws out of the side here. Just to make it easier to work on, since this thing is in a box, go ahead and take off this whole extruder here. Take off the extruder, just undo these screws on the side. They're also the same screws used for the vertical adjustment. There we go. Snip off the filament. And let's see how this moved. The throat there moved out of the heater block, just slid out of the heater block. Must not have been, yeah, it wasn't secure enough. You can tell it's wiggling. So just those two set screws there that need to be loosened and then push that back in and tighten it back up. The set screws are really loose. Should have checked all these screws in the very beginning. May be difficult to push it up now if there's plastic in there. Looks like all that was holding it was the wires. It's definitely not just pushing back in. So it's gonna require some more complex surgery, I think. Okay, so you get to see a teardown of this extruder and heater block. Take the fan shroud off, and the shroud should come out of the fan. There we go. Okay, the LED stays there too. So look at this, the shroud even has a diverter inside to split the air. Okay, this gives us better access here to the heater block, and I think the best thing to do is to take this off here. Okay, so I'm releasing the filament here, just pulling it out, and I guess there is like probably a blob of filament stuck in there where it's not allowing this Teflon tube to go all the way and bottom out. So what I'm gonna have to do is probably just heat up the heater block and then yank the filament out, and then keep it warm while I push the Teflon tube in. So this, as I suspected, this is not a hot, all metal hot end. It does use a Teflon tube that passes all the way through down to the top of the heater block. And so the heat goes around the Teflon tube and is absorbed by the heat sink. So the problem I ran into was just that these two screws right here were loose and it pushed the heater block out. So I'm gonna go heat this up. There was in fact a big plug of plastic in there. I heated it up, pulled out the filament, and there's a big plug of plastic that was jammed in there that was preventing the Teflon from bottoming out. So now it's still hot, and I just gotta be careful. So now I can slide this back on there, and you can see it bottom out completely in there. So just gotta reassemble everything, and now we know what it looks like in there. Attach the heat sink back on first. I'll put those screws. Oops. The screws for the heat sink back on. I'll let the heater block cool down some more. Just put one in loosely and then put the other in. Okay. And now I can make sure that if everything's good, no wires, nothing's pinched, then I can tighten this up a bit. All right, now the heater goes. So now I'm going to tighten back the heater block, the throat, into the heat sink. And what's strange is that these screws are not on the center line of the part. Therefore, they're digging into kind of like the side of the throat. And you'd have to be careful because if, depending on which screw you tighten first, it could actually like kind of push it out. It also maybe wants to rotate it too. So just trying to make sure these are really nice and tight. And there's two, which a lot of times I've only seen one, so that's something. But apparently two already was not enough, especially as you deal with like thermal expansion and contraction. There's two, the probably stainless in, of the throat expands differently than the aluminum. So the aluminum could expand more and then get loose on the throat. So it feels like that's pretty tight. Don't want to strip out the screws. The last thing to do is to put the fan shroud back in. So this one, there's a little detent right here that this fits into also. So kind of have to get it in there at the same time. Pop it in like that. There we go. If you didn't see how that happened, like, I kind of rotated it in like this. And then the screw is pretty well hidden back there. Let's see, where is it? Oh, the LED, I have to watch. Yeah, the LED went right back into the hole there. That one's already in position. And that screw is right here. It's right there. Oops. Maybe a ball end driver would help now. Actually, there's clearance if you go behind the heater block like this. Okay, that's back on. Push the LED down. Looks like it just kind of, LED just kind of floats. Does its thing. All right, check the routing of these wires. Push them back in here. Everything's plugged in. Okay, time to go put it back on the printer. gonna slide it back down here. I don't have any way to fix the height yet on this. I'd really like to have figure out some way to do that. So I'm gonna have to set the height again on, off of the table. And for right now, I'm just gonna slide it down and put the cover back on. That was upside down. I can actually slide the table underneath it, let it sit on the table. And tighten up these screws on the side, the cover, two on each side. Looks like the Z height might be okay because there's a little bit of plastic on the end of the tip. I'm just gonna temporarily set the lock the Z, and then I can get back to it in a minute when I do some calibration. Really love being able to take these extruders off with just disconnecting this cable. That's a really good feature. All right, now just gotta power it back up, feed the filament into it, and extrude a little bit, and then do a Z-height calibration. Next thing I'm doing right away also is checking these screws on the other extruder to make sure they're tight enough. And they do appear to be a little bit loose. It's hard to get in there because of the fan shroud. They are definitely not as tight as they could be. Yeah, they're loose. So that is a problem that you need to check on before using the extruders, that these screws are tight. Otherwise, you're going to run into the same issue I did.